Hello, fantasy footballers out there. Hello, first and goal earth out there. It is Sunday morning, 9:30, September 15th. We are in week two of the NFL season. Hopefully all of our first and goal podcast followers are out there. Hopefully the entire fantasy football world is listening. And I have my co-host with me, Mr. Dave Sager.
Whoa, sir. Co-host, I'm just a guest today. This is your shindig.
All right. I'll just call you some guy then. Hi, some guy.
I'll take it.
He's going to be joining us for the morning matchup today. We're going to be going through all the matchups in week two. We're going to be talking about injury reports. We're going to be talking about fantasy analysis. And at the end of it all, we're going to tell you who's going to win the game. Because that's what's most important, right, Dave?
Oh, of course, because people want to know everybody else's predictions, so we got to get ours in.
Absolutely. So hopefully you had your bacon, hopefully you had your eggs, because right now you're about to get some football.
If you're in the South, a little bit of grit.
Oh, God, don't get me started on grit.
Right there with you, man. We're both from the North.
Well, hopefully someone can hit us up on Twitter, send us a recipe, or maybe even invite us over someday to give us a salad. I like shrimp, too, so if you're out there listening, you got a solid shrimp and grit dish that you like to serve up, hit us up, First and Goal Pod, and we'd love to see a picture of your delicious shrimp and grits.
That's Dillon, not me. I'm good.
FYI,
I'll take meat and oatmeal.
I'm here, but I'm eating a cheese stick right now, so I'm a little busy.
Oh, yeah. That reminds me, First and Goalers. Jay is here. He's in the background. He's cranking levers and turning dials and all that sorts of things.
But, yeah. No, literally, his computer's that old, guys. He's cranking levers and turning dials. We're not kidding.
Oh, God. Well, let's just jump right into the matchup, shall we, guys?
Of course. Take us to it, buddy.
Well, first up, we have what could be a very exciting matchup. Two young, dynamic quarterbacks in Lamar Jackson and Kyler Murray when Arizona hosts. Well, actually, sorry about that. When the Baltimore Ravens host the Arizona Cardinals today, as far as the injury report goes, we have Jimmy Smith for the Ravens will be out. Mark Andrews,
that's a biggie.
And Hollywood, that is big. Mark Andrews and Marquise Hollywood Brown are questionable. Why do you think Jimmy Smith is so big? You know?
Because, I mean, he's one of the corners that do a lot of shutdown work, and he doesn't get talked about as much as other guys like a Stephon Gilmore. I mean, he does his work. He does everything he needs to. And maybe that's why he's not talked about, is because he's not also a media guy. Gilmore is. He's always doing interviews. Jimmy Smith is very quiet, very just kind of go on, do your job type player, and he does really damn good at it.
Also, when you consider the fact that Larry Fitzgerald just went for 113 yards and a touchdown last
in a fourth quarter. Just a quarter.
That's out there. That being said, how do you feel about Arizona traveling this week, taking on a pretty tough defense? I know they're without some key cogs such as C.J. Mosley and Terrell Suggs, who departed during the offseason. But do you feel like this Suggs on offense can get off to a quicker start?
Well, it's Suggs, the homecoming back to Baltimore. They're going to show him some love. But the thing is, they also lost Eric Weddle, C.J. Mosley, Za'Darius Smith. Those are four kind of main players that were on that defense. Yeah, you brought in Earl Thomas, but where's the inside linebacker? That was my key concern. And everyone says, oh, this defense is fine. Well, they faced a really, 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 really bad Miami team last week. Like, and I understand they balled out. The defense was good, but I got to see it for a consecutive week. And this offense woke up against the Detroit Lions last week and came to life like what it's supposed to do. So, it's going to be exciting because of the fact of Jimmy Smith's injury, so you're going to leave some holes open for Kyler. I just don't think – I don't know. I think Arizona at least has some formidable defense. Like, you have Terrell Suggs and Chandler Jones coming off the edge for Arizona, and those are a completely different animal than what you faced in Miami last week. They barely have any pass rushers. Like, I'm pretty sure they have, like, second and third stringers because they got rid of everyone.
Yeah, that's true. I'm starting Lamar in a couple of my leagues today, but I'm certainly not expecting the same type of performance as we had last week in Miami. Even though it's a home game, and even though Arizona's defense, you know.
Well, Dillon, you know what, though? It's just Miami was such a bad defense. That's the only thing. Is I have to see it again. And Arizona presents a more formidable defense. I'm not saying they're top 10 or top 15, but it's formidable. Like, you at least have still some safeties and some corners. And, I mean, and plus the pass rush, they have no inside linebacker, really. But, I mean, you can still do enough to delay things. So, we'll see.
Because you've got Patrick Peterson still out on his suspension. You've got Robert Alford on IR. So now you are down to some lower-level cornerbacks out there for Arizona. I mean, it certainly gives me hope. I think Lamar can still have a nice day through the air, just not nearly the same type of day we saw last week. Now, with Hollywood Brown being limited, what have you read up on him, Dee?
From what I've seen, he's still listed as questionable. I went through this a little bit ago, and it's nothing really changing out there. It says he's expected to play. It actually just came up on the TV right now. It says hip, expected to play, questionable. I mean, but all it takes is one wrong twitch, one wrong move, and that hip is re-aggravated and he's out for the game. Because I know they're not going to risk him going back in for the season. So I would be very light on his touches today just to make sure he doesn't get hurt. I'm not saying to sit him, but I wouldn't expect more, maybe even like 7 or 8 targets.
No, I wouldn't sit Brown today. I think he's a good flex option. Played 12 snaps last week and turned 4 catches into 147 yards and 2 touchdowns. So, I mean, we're talking about super efficiency with this guy. It's just like you said, I mean, it only takes one hit to the hip. I mean, maybe a helmet, and he's out for the game. So
just a wrong turn on a route. That's all it takes.
Yeah, exactly. If you have Hollywood Brown, put him out there. All right, yeah. So then we have Mark Andrews, who, you know, he only had a certain percentage of snaps last week. He was pretty efficient with them. Arizona's defense, like we've mentioned a couple times now, is more formidable than Miami's defense. And I would expect them to put a little bit more better coverage on the tight ends for Baltimore. But definitely you're playing Lamar, you're playing Hollywood Brown, you're certainly playing Mark Ingram. Both three guys are good to go. Kyler Murray, I mean, you're not expecting a big day, but definitely got to start him. You drafted him to play him, and now you're playing him. David Johnson, you have to play from where you drafted him. I don't expect this to be a plus matchup, but he'll certainly be fine. And look for another big day out of Larry Fitzgerald, considering his performance last week and no Jimmy Smith out there for Baltimore.
That all about Christian Kirk?
Christian Kirk, maybe. I want to see him with another big game before I'm a Kirk believer.
Okay.
All
right.
Well,
yeah.
Well,
I got a question.
What about MVS for the Packers now that they have all their corners are seem to be getting injured? And Aaron Jones.
You're bringing the Packers into this? You figured out a way to shoehorn the Packers into this matchup?
I think he was going game by game, buddy.
I'm just over here talking about people to play or whatever. I want to know. These are important decisions for my fantasy team.
Well, I got a report on MBS if you don't mind, Dillon.
No, go ahead.
So, Trey Waynes and Xavier Rhodes are playing, but the Vikings' third and fourth string look like they're going to be out. Mike Hughes and McKenzie Alexander. Alexander, I know, is out because of a dislocated elbow he's rehabbing from. Mike Hughes has a knee problem he's been battling, and he's doubtful. And speaking of which, I thought the NFL got rid of the whole doubtful designation.
Yeah, I thought so, too. Maybe they brought it back because of the fantasy world.
No, it was probable.
Wouldn't have it.
Well, I mean, last year they totally got rid of it.
It was probable, yeah.
Okay.
Doubtful, out kind of thing, and they got rid of it. You're either doubtful or out. Now, there's no more.
Well, okay, he's doubtful, and it looks like he's not going to play. The Vikings won't risk it. Mark Fields was supposed to be the guy that they're going to replace him with a fifth-string corner. Guess what? The Vikings went and waived him and picked up an extra linebacker. So they're down to their sixth and seventh cornerbacks on the slots in the dime package. So you're looking at guys like MBS, Allison, Kumaro, Davis that might have big days, even the tight ends, because you're going to end up with some of those slot corners and some zones on a lot better players. So those are two rookies, by the way. It's Meters and Boyd. Chris Meters and Trey or it's Chris Boyd and Trey Meters, two rookie cornerbacks for the Vikings, and they have little to no playing experience. And they're going up against Rodgers, and you know how he likes to use every kind of weapon he has. And I just feel that the lower string wide receivers and the tight ends are going to have a day today. Aaron Jones, though, I don't know. We saw the Bears defense last week, Jay, Dillon. I don't know what your opinion is. I need to see him getting going, and they still have a really damn good front seven.
Well, I could see Jones getting plenty of snaps at home today, but at the same time, you know, you got to worry about the hamstring. You got to worry about it only being week two and one in the guys to last throughout the entire season. And, I mean, Jamal Williams got quite a few looks last week. So, I'm not trusting Aaron Jones today. If you got him on the team, if you have to flex him, so be it. But hopefully there's someone else out there on the waiver wire that you can go pick up and plug in for Aaron Jones. I'm just not confident in him today. Vikings, they always swarm the linebackers, and Harrison Smith are constantly swarming all over the place, stuffing that underneath stuff. I think if you're going to succeed on the Vikings, it has to be deep, and it's just not a you know, it's nothing Aaron Jones is going to be a part of.
Jay, you happy with that answer or no?
Dead silence.
I guess he wasn't happy. What? You just angered him. Way to go, Dillon.
I'm sorry.
No. So what's your next game, brother? What's another game you're keeping an eye on?
Well, let's just go to the next one. I have Baltimore beating Arizona at home. I'll just wrap up saying that. Next up, we have Dallas visiting
Washington. I have Arizona upsetting Baltimore.
Oh, okay. I like that.
21-20. I think Arizona makes another late comeback, down by a touchdown, 2014, and they end up getting it to old reliable Larry Fitzgerald.
Dude, I hope you're right. I mean, this should be a fun day of just watching two young kids running around, slinging the rock. You know, some questionable defenses, but like you said, Suggs homecoming, that plays into it. And so I'm excited for this matchup. I really am. Next up, we have one of the best rivalries in football, one of the oldest, one of the most enjoyable to watch. Takes you back to Staubach, takes you back to Feisman, takes you back to Doug Williams and all those guys. We've got Dallas visiting Washington. The only injury for Dallas today, Kayvon Austin's going to be out. Otherwise, they're dealing with a pretty healthy team. Washington, on the other hand, not a very healthy team. We have Jordan out. We have Darius Geis out. And, you know, they're not dealing with a full hand. They're going to plug in the old man Adrian Peterson today after being a healthy scratch last week. So we'll see how that plays out. I know Peterson was upset about it. There's